Hello, this is Boggs, and this is a short tutorial on how you can use made transitions on DaVinci Resolve. Firstly, I have to say that whenever you are buying a product of mine, either they are transitions, overlays, compositing elements, just elements, or whatever, you will always find inside the download folder, except of the actual files, you will also find the preview all HTML. And if you double click on it, your explorer will open, and you will be able to preview all the files and can choose by number whichever you want. So let's say you want to use 16, okay, you check here 16, okay, good, you go back to your editing software, just drag and drop 16 and play with it. Anyway, that's that, so let's get started. Here we are in DaVinci Resolve 16. Let's import in our media pool two footages to be used as examples. Let's go to okay, I will use the liquid transitions. Inside the folder, you will see all the transitions, out and ins. Optically, you can always define which kind of transition each one is by the first frame. If it's white in the beginning, that means it's an out transition. If it is an in, then it's black. So, the most common mistake when people trying to use mate in Resolve is to just take one transition or mate and import it as regular footage inside the media pool. That's not the case for us, so I will remove it. Let's take 11 until 13, 14, 16. Okay, let's import all of these. Select them, right click, add to media pool as mates. That's the trick. And on your left bottom corner, you will see this symbol icon, and that means that the Resolve recognized them as mates. So let's move on and go to the edit tab. Let's bring the first footage, come on, the second one, and we have those footages. The transition we want to occur on top of this one, so select the footage above, go to the color tab, select the node of the footage, right click on it, add mate, timeline mate, and let's take, 12 in. I'm planning to use this in the beginning of the footage, so I want an in transition. Okay, now footage and mate are connected, but we need one more thing, and that's right click on the empty area over here and add an alpha output, and now connect the mate with the output, which is this blue dot over here. Now let's play, and you will see that the transition occurs just fine, but it's looping. In order to fix that, select again your mate, go to the key tab over here and uncheck the loop checkbox. Now if you go to the beginning, the transition will play only once. And then we have this problem. Underneath, after the transition is over, we start again to see the underneath footage. And that's because the transitions can't be as long as every footage you will use, you know? They have just the animation in time. So you have to extend it, and that's very easy to do. You can go back to the edit, locate where the transition is ending exactly. You can use your keyboard arrows in order to go frame by frame. I'm using the right keyboard right now. And that's the end of the transition, so one frame back. We will take the cut tool, cut the footage over here, and then again with the arrow, select the second one. We don't need any kind of mate on this one anymore. So go back to color, select the mate on the second one and delete it. And if we go back, let's play it, you will see that the transition plays just fine and the footage continues to play. So let's say we want to place an out transition on the footage also, in order to fade out, you know, from the footage to black or to a footage underneath, whatever. Select again the footage and let's say the transition, it couldn't be more than 2 seconds. So I will leave 2 seconds, something like that. I will take the cut tool, cut it, okay. Select the part of the footage, the last one that we want to use the out transition. Go again to the color tab, right click, add mate, come on. Let's say I want the 12 out, okay. Again, the same procedure. We connect the mate to the alpha output, and with the mate selected, again to the key tab, unloop, unlock, and let's go to the end of the footage, few frames back maybe, and now we will use the offset attribute, but not the slider because it's extremely sensitive. Let's go with the numbers. I'm just holding the left mouse click and dragging left, and right now I'm slowly reducing offsetting time until, like now, I will see the transition. And now let's go to the end of the footage and offset the transition time until it's just out, something like that. And we are done. Let's go back to the edit, and as you can see, from this point the transition starts to occur and it's ending. But before, we have a black frame, black frames for this part, and that's the same problem we had in the transition in. So let's find frame by frame where the transition starts. Over here, cut it, arrow tool, select the footage we don't want any mate on it, color, select mate, delete, we're done. And everything plays just fine. And if you don't want to have all those cuts together in your edit, after you are done, you can select them all, right click, new compound clip, rename it to whatever you want, I will say test, whatever, and create. And now the footage is nested and it's just one clip, which plays just fine, and you can do whatever you want with it. And if you go over here, which is this footage, the nested footage, and right click on it and go open in timeline, you can again make any kind of adjustments you want, and then you can go again back to your main timeline. That's how you can use mate transitions and in general mates in DaVinci Resolve. I hope this tutorial was helpful. And in case you didn't understand my accent, I'm sorry for that. That's the best I can do. I wish you a great day. Cheers. Bye.